here. It's fantastic to see you. I hope that you're having an awesome day. Thank you for giving me a little bit of your time to see how everything went with my December makeup bag items. I had a lot of fun wearing some fun, festive burgundy eyeshadow in particular over the holidays. And so I've made quite a bit of progress, and there are some things that I've had some realizations about that maybe you'll find helpful for your collection. So let's get into it. The first thing that I wanted to talk about, I actually applied for this on Octoly several weeks ago, and it's been something that I've used ever since I got it in the mail. It is the Susan Ciminelli Cleansing Milk with Lavender and Calendula Extract. It comes in a bottle like this. Pardon me as my hands get in the way. This is a really nice cleanser. If you're intrigued by a product like this, go on and check my description box below. I'll put a link to take you directly to the Octoly website so that you can look up ingredient information, skin testimonials, and things like that. All of that information will be there for you. I was really intrigued to apply to review this product because it has such a great ingredients list. The first ingredient is purified water, sweet almond oil. There is glycerin in this, but there's also avocado oil and other things. It's non-greasy, lightweight, and the back of the box says they combine essential oils, lavender and orange blossom, avocado oil, and sea kelp. The predominant fragrance of this cleanser is lavender. And one of the things that I've noticed about it, it says you can use it to, you know, to take off your makeup and be like a makeup remover and pollutant kind of cleanser. I still need to go through with a makeup remover, especially when it comes to mascara. I don't wear waterproof mascara, but this isn't strong enough to take that stuff off completely on its own. So if you're interested in a new cleanser, this is worth trying out because it's very soothing. It doesn't leave my skin dry or tight or crepey feeling. It's really, really nice. It's just make sure you go in with a makeup remover before you use this. One of my favorite ways to cleanse my skin with this particular product is with the Real Techniques. I guess this is the exfoliation sponge. I don't remember specifically what it's called, but it looks like this. You wet it and then it has kind of a rougher texture to go on and exfoliate your face. It works really well in combination with this cleanser. So I wanted to share that with you. And like I said, check that description box if you are curious for more information from the Octoly website. So I was really thrilled to get this and, you know, see how I liked it and give my honest opinion of it for you because it smells good and it does really nice things, but definitely it's not a makeup remover by any standards. So that's that. And then another product that I really kind of felt about by the end of the month, I purchased this e.l.f. BB cream in the shade Buff. I wanted something really light because the other product that I applied to review for from Octoly is the Clarin Everlasting Compact Foundation in the shade Beige. I did not want to have a heavy foundation that was full coverage and then cover it on top with a powder that is full coverage. So I picked this up. I'm not a huge fan of this. I had about a week of wear where my skin looked great with it. Other than that, I was really, really shiny and oily. This is not a product that I will repurchase because I did want to see if maybe it was my serum that was interacting with it, or if a new powder would change the effect of it, or, you know, I went through the steps of giving it several chances to prove for me whether it would be great or not. And every time I always ended up shiny within a couple of hours. And like I said, over the course of wearing this for 4 weeks, I really only had about a good week. I guess hormonally, my skin cooperated with this particular product. But, you know, 1 week, considering I gave it a whole month worth of usage, this is not something that I'm going to put on my radar list again. The price point is great, but for me, this was not a fantastic thing for my skin. The bonus is there's not even quite a whole fluid ounce in this bottle, so you are able to use it up fairly quickly. I was able to finish off the majority of this bottle in a month, so there you go. Then, like I mentioned, the powder that I wore for all of the December month was this Clarin Everlasting Compact in Beige. Anytime I see Clarin products on the Octoly website, I apply to review them because I love the brand and I've consistently had success with anything that they have produced. I've used their skincare line for years. Via Octoly, I've been able to try quite a bit of their makeup. I have a serum that I'm gonna be phasing in for my January makeup bag. This is great. Now, as far as this powder is concerned, it's not a full coverage powder if you're wanting a powder foundation. If you like really light makeup, this is a great choice for you. There is a slight fragrance to this powder. It's not overwhelming, but it's definitely enough where you notice it, kind of a slight floral scent. And then, well, actually it kind of has a little bit of a cucumbery melon kind of vibe to it, but it doesn't last long where you have to worry about, am I going to smell this all day long? And you know, my favorite way to wear this, there was a sponge applicator in the bottom. I took that out and I ended up consistently applying it with this e.l.f. Face brush because I wanted a really light dusting of this all over my face, and it worked really well for that. It is the kind of powder that you definitely want to touch up, you know, maybe once or twice. Like if you're applying your makeup in the morning and you're wanting it to last all day through work, it's a powder that you might want to keep in your purse to touch up just in the afternoon when you start getting a little shiny. I noticed that I needed to touch it up a little bit with this BB cream just to take off some of the shininess of this, but it worked really, really well for that. So great choice for, you know, just a lovely setting powder, but not yet heavy enough to be like crazy coverage if you want a really light powder foundation. Then the next thing I was able to get through, let's talk about the other two kind of skin foundation type things. In terms of primer / moisturization, I wanted to, you know, get the progress that I could off this It Cosmetics Feel the Moment Skin Rejuvenating Hydrating Primer Serum. I've had a lot of trouble finding this on Ulta or Sephora or even the It Cosmetics website, so I don't know if they've discontinued this product. It's really nice in terms of hydrating your skin. The scent on it's a little intense. I mean, really overwhelming with the tea tree. I don't mind it, but it definitely makes me want to have like not even a pump into my hand before I apply it to my face because it is so intense. But I wanted more hydration this past month because we've had freakishly cold temperatures, and then it's really, really hot within several days, and then it's back to cold. So this has been really great to incorporate into my routine, and I love the fact that when it absorbs into my skin, it is very quick. It doesn't leave a greasy finish, even though I was noticing the greasy finish with this. You know, I didn't have issues with other foundations and things using this serum. So once again, you know, I don't know, maybe it's a combination of those two together, but this is pretty good, but I want to move it out of my collection. And then as far as setting spray, I was able to move out my Mario Badescu facial spray with aloe, cucumber, and green tea. If you're not a fan of the rose scent, give this fragrance a try from Mario Badescu. It's very, very fresh, light. It has a green color to the setting spray instead of the rose color, so it's a nice alternative. This was just a sample size that I bought from Ulta. I really, really enjoyed it. It's something that I will continue to repurchase in the future after I try, you know, several other setting sprays because I'm ready to kind of branch out and do something different. But this was really, really great. And it is cruelty-free if you're wanting a cruelty-free product. Then let's get to makeup, eyeshadow. I made tons of progress on my palettes the past couple of, you know, weeks. So first off, my Lorac Mega Pro, the shades that I focused on, started off with just lilac, and then I went on and started kind of zoning in on Merlot and a little bit of maroon. So here you go. I'm almost to the point where I'm gonna be clearing out the last little bits of lilac when I dedicate my time to that color again. I've moved on to a shade in the Kat Von D Mi Vita Loca Remix palette because that is my palette for 2018, but I'm still kind of quietly working on this one as we move into the future. And then when I finished Cherry Cordial out of the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, I moved into Merlot for a while. So because I had a little bit of wear on it, again, it was easy to hit pan. It's really easy to hit pan in Lorac shades because they're so powdery and soft. So that was a pleasant surprise to see the pan in that. And then I also started in on maroon when I finished Amaretto from my Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. So not a lot of progress in there, but enough where you can see a little bit of a dip. So fun times. Fun times on making some more progress on eyeshadow. And then the other two palettes that I pulled out, I also used my Lorac Pro palettes, or Pro 2, because I specifically wanted to focus on the shade Cool Gray as a contour. This is a shade that's not super flattering for me on my eyes, but lightly applied, it works really, really well as a contour. So I went in with Cool Gray, and I also had a little bit of progress on Jade, because when I ran out of Gilded Ganache from my Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, this was a nice alternative, because I was panning, or, you know, I'm not finished with this, but I was in the process of panning my Clinique Quick Liner for Eyes Intense and the shade Intense Ivy. These two work really, really well together. So Intense Ivy from Clinique and Jade, it pulls out so many of those beautiful green tones, because Jade is one of those shades. Again, I've noticed this with Lorac. They're notorious for like making these really deep shades that are black shadow with the shimmer that they're supposed to be. Jade operates like that for me. Like, it's just really black looking with like hints of green. So I usually, you know, use an olive or deep green cream product to kind of bring out the green tones. So I can't recommend enough that Clinique pencil with this Jade, and I'm really impressed with the progress I made on Cool Gray. So good stuff. And then the last palette, I only focused on one shade. It's my Z palette. I really wanted to zone in on this shade from a Bare Minerals quad. I don't remember which quad it was. I'll have to look it up. But this is the shade that I substituted it in for Champagne Truffle. Once I finished that out of the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, I used this as a highlighter on my eyes as well as my face. I love that shade. So, substantial pan. That feels really good. I will be going back to it at some point this year with my Kat Von D Mi Vita Loca palette, because now that I've hit pan, it's like, let's do this, let's finish it, you know? So really, really exciting. I'm very thrilled with what I was able to accomplish, not only with that, and then I'm also going to include my finale video for the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, so feel free to click that link in the card above and go on and see what I learned as I pan the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, and I share some tips and tricks that help me to stay motivated and keep using that palette, and you know, some tips and tricks to make some of those shadows work if you are looking to also get some more use out of your palette as well. So feel free to check it out if you're interested. And then the other things, I also used this NARS Laguna Bronzer. This is in the Sun Shimmer formula, I think, or Sun Washed. I'll go on and link a picture of the original product in the car or over here somewhere. The bronzer, when I first started using this, I wasn't really sure how I felt about it, because when it has the ridges like that, it gets hard panned so fast. I mean, ridiculously hard, where there's no pigmentation. It almost made me get to the point where I was like, I need to return this, because it was just annoying me to no end. But one of the tips I want to share with you, if you're interested in trying this product, if you take a paring knife and just scrape off that top layer, it works so much better. I really appreciate this bronzer now. It's a great color without being too cool tone, but it's definitely not orange. So I recommend this, but once again, just kind of scrape off those layers. And the brush that I'm using to apply this is just an e.l.f. blush brush in a 3 shape around my face. And I'm no longer dealing with those hard pan issues. Cause I mean, I gotta tell you, that was so annoying to deal with that. Like, incredibly annoying. But now I've gotten to a point where I've really learned to love this bronzer. So once again, yet another bonus of giving a couple of weeks to some makeup products, isn't it? And then I feel like I'm gonna say goodbye to an old friend, but this is my Tarte Amazonian Clay Blush in Blushing Bride. I have been diligently using this for a very long time. It has been in so many panning projects. I've owned it for years. It's a beautiful color. It's one of my most favorite blushes. And I wanted to give you kind of a last look at, you know, the progress that I made, because it has come time to say goodbye to this beautiful blush. I've noticed in the past couple of weeks that it has become fainter and fainter on my cheeks, that I've had to work harder to get more product out of it. I don't remember when I bought this. I know it's been quite a while that I've had this in my collection, so it is time to bid adieu to this beautiful shade. I do have other blushes in my collection. In fact, I have the, because I love Tarte, I think the Tarte Amazonian Clay blushes are my most favorite out of all the blushes I've ever tried. I mean, NARS was my favorite for a long time, but once I panned several of those out, I was kind of like, it's time to move on, and I fell in love with Tarte, and so I have those blush palettes, and so it makes it a little bit easier to go on and say goodbye to this one, because I think there's a similar color to Blushing Bride in one of those palettes. So fun times, and if not, I will repurchase this at some point because it's a beautiful plummy mauve glow that just gives you a very flattering, sophisticated cheek without being crazy over the top. So I love pairing this with burgundies. Even when I want to wear basic brown eyeshadow, or plums, or pinks, or even with like mauves and things, this is fantastic. I love using it as a blush and then running it very, very gently through my crease to kind of warm up looks. It's fantastic. So goodbye to an old friend, because man, this blush has been with me a very, very long time, and I've had so many good memories and experiences with it. So then kind of moving on that note, lip products. I pulled out like my new system of doing lip products from now on when I do my makeup bag is I've organized all of my similar color family lipsticks and lip liners together in separate bags. And so for December, I kind of went with like a MAC Rebel kind of vibe with the lip products that I chose. And I have like an, two e.l.f. lip crayons that are kind of similar to each other. This Bite Beauty and Mousse Bouche lipstick. And then I had a Revlon lipstick and something else that are all quite similar in tone. But I noticed over the course of December that I pulled these two products out the most. And this is the MAC lip pencil in the shade Nightingale, with my Texas accent there. This is what it looks like. It's a beautiful punch of like fuchsia, but kind of more on the burgundy side. Again, kind of MAC Rebel vibe. In fact, those lip kits, when they advertise for MAC on the Macy's website, the MAC website and whatnot, where you can get the lip liner, lipstick duo, Nightingale is paired with Rebel. So just kind of tips and tricks on pairing some things. I wanted to make it easier for me to find my lip products, hence why I'm doing the whole Ziploc bag thing, because I want to be more consistent about rotating through and using up some more lip products out of my collection. And then I pulled, like just every day, this ended up being the lipstick I wore, including in that Pan That Palette finale video that I just posted. But this is the Bite Beauty and Mousse Bouche lipstick in the shade Beetroot. I adore this shade. It is so creamy and beautiful. I love these two together. And what I do with the Nightingale is I go on and I fill in or take line. I can speak today. I line my lips and then I fill in the corners to give a little bit more foundation because this lipstick tends to bleed. It's just one of the things I don't like about this formula. Like, it's so creamy that it's like crazy. I do need to wear a lip liner with this, but at the same time, I love how smooth and pigmented and just fresh the ingredients are. But that's one of the things I'm planning to do in 2018 is I'm going to go in pretty hard on all my Bite Beauty and Mousse Bouche lipsticks, because these things do go bad a little bit more quickly than a traditional lipstick because they are food grade ingredients. So note to self, you know, if you're wanting to pan things in 2018, that would be a good place to start too, when kind of evaluating your lipstick collection. If you have a lot of Bite Beauty lipsticks or 100% pure, some of these more natural products, those are great things to go on and take charge of and finish out. And then the other thing I wanted to talk about, like in terms of a product you may not have thought about necessarily, inner rim brighteners. Instead of using a nude pencil for December, I pulled out my Pixie Extra Eye Brightener Liner, and it's a beautiful ballet pink shade. This really does wonders if you're huge fans of burgundy eyeshadows and purples, and especially since ultraviolet is the color of the year, we're going to be seeing a lot of purple looks, teals, navies, and things like that. This is an awesome product to pick up. You can find it at Target, or also I'm trying to think what other brands make a kind of a pinky pencil. Benefit, I believe NYX has one. I don't know officially, but I think e.l.f. might have one too. I was kind of like poking around to see if there were other brands, because the Pixie can be kind of expensive if you're wanting to stay within the drugstore price range. So I'm looking at other alternatives to see, because I should be finished with this probably within the next couple of months with some more consistent use. So I've put it away for a while with my January makeup bag, but this is a great, great product. So love this. It's worth putting on your radar to check out. And then in terms of brow pencils, I've fallen back in love with kind of using brow products again because I've used eyeshadow for so long. I found this Anastasia Brow Wiz in medium brown in my makeup stash. There wasn't a whole lot in it, so I went on and just finished it off, and then I went and purchased this NYX microbrow pencil in the shade ash brown. They're literally dupes for each other. Same color, same thing. Awesome. So high-end price, drugstore price. So definitely, like, I'm back in love with brow pencils. I'm going to go on and continue using this NYX pencil, and who knows, I might go on and just kind of make more of a habit of using brow pencils in the future, because it's kind of nice to change from using eyeshadow in my brows. So definitely worth the time as well. One thing that was not worth the time, this number 7 Lash Impact Ultra Instant False Lash Volume Mascara. The packaging on this is awesome. Like, that's what suckered me into getting it. However, the mascara is not what I was hoping it was going to be. It smells like gasoline when you open it up, which is kind of appalling. But then when you actually put on the mascara, it started off okay. But then, you know, not even an hour later, I noticed there was tons of flaking on my cheeks. And I just, no. So it was fun to have a glittery packaged mascara with, you know, gold. But other than that, that mascara was kind of a dud. And then last but not least, I have my Maybelline Lasting Drama Waterproof Gel Pencil in the shade Sleek Onyx. I love this liner. I made so much progress on this particular pencil this last month. So I'm going to go on and put it away. Just to try out some other things from my collection and shop my stash, but I love this formula. In fact, I have several of the colors from the Maybelline Lasting Drama waterproof gel pencils because they are fantastic on my lower lash lines. So I have like the purple one, the teal one, and kind of a coppery colored one. These are these are great. So that is about it. Once again, thank you so much for giving me a little bit of your time. I hope that you found kind of helpful information. If there are some things that you're looking to incorporate into your makeup collection, or maybe be inspired to pull some things out of your stash and have some fun, I wish you all the best. Have lots of fun with your makeup and be on the lookout. I'm going to be posting my January makeup bag items. So I look forward to seeing you real soon. Take care.